Good day, everyone. I'm Teacher Justin, and welcome to Math with Teacher Justin. And for today, we're going to talk about percent, base, and rate. So, bago tayo mag-proceed sa mga word problems or solving, let's identify first definition of base, rate, and percentage. So, start tayo with percentage. So, percentage is often a part. So, it is the part of the base. So, it is the product of the base and the rate. So, pag binultiply natin yung base at yung rate, ito yung makukuha natin, yung percentage. Then, we have the base. Base is the principal amount. So, in short, ito yung initial number, or in terms of word problem, this is the initial amount or money na kukuhanan natin ng percentage. And last one, rate, is the relationship between the base and the percentage, and common siyang naka-express sa percent. So, ito yung nakikita nating 50%, 25%, 20%. Okay, so, na-define na natin si percentage, base, and rate. Let's have our examples. Alright. Okay, let's have our first example. So, first item natin, 25% of 180. So, first thing that we need to do here is for us to get our given. So, first, ito, makikita natin na mayroong percent symbol dito. So, that would be our rate. So, R is equal to 25%. Now, we have to convert this to decimal by moving the decimal point 2 units to the left. So, we will move it. Magiging 0.25 siya. Now, we will proceed to the next given. So, we have 25% of 180. So, we have the word of, and that word of is commonly translated to the operation multiplication. So, 25% times 180. So, since our formula is percentage is equal to base times rate, so this number 180 would be our base kasi lagi siyang naka-multiply sa rate. So 25% times 180, that would be the base, yung 180. Then we're looking for the percentage. Now our formula to use is na mention na kanina, percentage is equal to base times rate. So all we need to do is to substitute our given. We have percentage is equal to 180 times 0.25. Then we multiply it. Okay, that will give us the percentage is equal to 45. And that's it. Ta-da! Alright. Okay, let's proceed to our next item. So what is 48% of 540? So first thing that we need to do is to identify our given. So we have the rate. Kasi meron tayong percent symbol dito, and we have to convert this to decimal by moving the decimal point 2 places to the left. So, magiging 0.48 siya. Tapos, again, looking at our problem, meron tayong word na of, so we have to convert this to multiplication, and we know that the rate is always multiplied to the base. So, this number right here, 540, is going to be the base. Now, we're solving for the percentage. So, to solve this, we will use the formula. P is equal to B times R. So, we substitute our given. So, what is 540 times 0.48? That will give us 259.2. And that would be our final answer. Alright. Okay, let's have our first example. So, first item natin, 25% of 180. So, first thing that we need to do here is for us to get our given. So, first, ito, makikita natin na mayroong percent symbol dito. So, that would be our rate. So, R is equal to 25%. Now, we have to convert this to decimal by moving the decimal point 2 units to the left. So, we will move it. Magiging 0.25 siya. Now, we will proceed to the next given. So, we have 25% of 180. So, we have the word of, and that word of is commonly translated to the operation multiplication. So, 25% times times 180. So since our formula is percentage is equal to base times rate, so this would not this number 180 would be our base kasi lagi siyang naka-multiply sa rate. So 25% times 180, that would be the base, yung 180. Then we're looking for the percentage. Now our formula to use is na mention na kanina, percentage is equal to base times rate. So all we need to do is to substitute our given. We have percentage is equal to 180 times 0.25. Then we multiply it. Okay, that will give us the percentage is equal to 45. And that's it. Ta-da! All right.